An acute shortage of petrol hit Western Kenya, the North Rift and some rural areas who are mainly supplied by independent oil marketers, and these blame the shortage on a mismatch in pricing. Dealers said wholesalers had stopped supplying them, wary of government's commitment to a state subsidy amid calls of assurance of compensation by wholesalers to enable dealers release the fuel again. We hope this will not spill over into Uganda, especially motorists are dealing with a recent hike in the prices back home. Welcome to the Business Show. Now here are stories that made the business week. 400 billion shillings transacted through digital channels daily, according to Bank of Uganda. Trademark East Africa commits 6 billion to boost market standards. UNBS launches standard for edible insects. Petrol crisis hits North Rift and Western Kenya. Oil prices fall after Shanghai starts lockdown.
We are continuing in the field of water and urban development, supporting also energy.
The market for mushrooms is huge in the region. For example, in Kenya and Congo, the market is huge.
Welcome to the show. Now, for 10 years, the French Development Agency has been working on building infrastructure that supports the private sector. In Views from the Top this week, we speak to Hatem Chokron, the AFD director, on how this program is transforming not only Uganda, but the East African region as a whole.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the French Embassy. We're for a little bit more than 2 years and a half now. AFD is a financial, international financial institution that dedicated to development finance according to the French policy in the field. In Uganda, we are dedicated to the funding of four pillars. First is water and sanitation, which is half of our portfolio. We've been financing water and sanitation for Kampala. We've been financing water and sanitation for Masaka, Bara, and Sinjo, and we are contemplating financing a similar project in some secondary cities. The second pillar is about electricity. We are financing from the generation to the transmission and up to the rural electrification connections. The third pillar is about urban development. We are funding street lighting for Kampala. We are contemplating other development projects in some secondary cities, newly nominated secondary cities in the country. And we have some mobility projects like the Kampala Expressway, Kampala Jinja Expressway, which a lot of people have heard about. We are also participating in the discussions to come up with a bus rapid transit in Kampala, together with other donors like the World Bank, and the last pillar is about private sector finance through some credit lines with state-owned banks like Uganda Development Bank, Housing Finance Bank, etc. AFD brings long maturity funding through soft loans to the government, made to the government, and with its guarantee. It's the maturity is between 15 and 20 years, which gives a less possible burden on the state budget, and which is the most adapted for social investment. This is dedicated to financing of development projects, which requires very soft loans, soft finance, especially when it's related to social objects like water and sanitation, like a project for dedicated to improvement of living condition of population. So we are completely untied from any national offer. Our aim is creating impacts with the most durable equipment selected, made and designed with the best expertise that you might find all over the world. Soft loans, it means that the interest rate is subsidized by the French taxpayer, so that the interest rate is very, very low, and it's very close to zero, so it allows really the government to invest for people into very useful projects like water and sanitation, which is absolutely necessary for health and for the decent living of population. What makes our offer different from other source of financing is that we have partnerships with other donors, and we get grants dedicated to us from their part, which improves our project, which allow us to fund technical assistance, capacity building, in order to enhance the capacity of state-owned companies or utilities and ministries to implement the project simply. What makes us also different is that we believe that development is not only about infrastructure, it's also about sports and culture, because we believe that people need to benefit from other services than the infrastructure, which are the basics. We are funding quite a number of organizations in sport field through calls for proposals. We have one that is dedicated to youth for mental health, and we've been funding an NGO which is called Watoto Wasoka, dedicated to football in the slums. We have quite also a lot of initiatives linked to Paris 2024 Olympic Games. So we have a yearly calls for proposal. The last one, which was financed up to 4 million euro for Africa, was closed in 15th of February. So the next one will be launched in 2023, and really I encourage all the academies, sport academies in Uganda to apply to this course for projects. We also fund the culture industry, so small projects that bring quality offer in the culture field. We are funding the Niege School, which is related to Niege Festival. We have been also funding some small projects in the cultural field. I will just give some examples like Visa, which is an application, a digital application dedicated to promotion of artists, Crossroads for sound production, and many others that we've been supporting through really programs, long programs, to support them to upscale and bring back better quality, create jobs, and bring back local offers to share with population.
All right, what are some of the projects that you're focusing on now, and are there some success stories that you'd like to share with us?
As for today, we are continuing in the field of water and urban development, supporting also energy. Those are linked to the National Development Plan 3 of the government and the Vision 2040. So we are supporting implementation of water and sanitation in the secondary cities. We are working more particularly on the three cities of Hoima, Lira and Fort Portal. We are also working on the funding of irrigation projects. As you know, only 2% of the capacity of irrigation is exploited in the country, and the need is huge for a more reliable agriculture, fighting against climate change, and bringing more livelihood to rural population. We are also contemplating financing some development projects in the urban field, in secondary cities, to bring better drainage, better marketplaces, enhance the capacity of the city of coping with an increasing population.
So where would you like
but
to?
I didn't answer the second part of your.
Oh,
question,
the second part
is,
of the question was success
part.
Stories.
The success stories.
Yes.
We have one major success story, which is water and sanitation for Kampala, which is really a big project, nearly 400 million euro. Have been invested in Kampala. This project is composed by the hydro drinkable water treatment plant that is going to double the water available for Kampala citizens. And the project has been commissioned in June last year, and is quite a success. The needs are huge. As you know, the population of Kampala is growing very fast, and especially in the COVID circumstance, having more supply of water is very important for the population. So we are very proud. I say we because we did not finance it alone. We were together with other financing partners like FW, like the European Union, the EIB, but we were lead, and we are very proud of the result because it's a measure shift in the provision of drinkable water for the city of Kampala.
All right, interesting. So where would you like to put your interest, your emphasis rather, moving forward? And how can small organizations get some funding?
We believe really that those two sectors bring a major opportunities to the youth. You know, half of the population is less than 16 years old in the country, and it's important to provide them with sport activities and bring some cultural offer in the country. And we target small organizations through calls for proposals, call for projects. So we launch several of them each year, and it's up to those small organizations to apply, to present projects. And we select them. We have selection committee, and we select the best project among them, and we support them through coaching, through funding that allows them to upscale, to implement the project they proposed, and as I said, to create jobs and the activity, and improve the cultural and sport offer in the city.
Let me just build up on that a bit. Are there particular things you're looking out for that these organizations must be able to meet before they apply for this funding?
Well, it's mostly focused on the quality of the project. You know, we are very sensitive to projects that foster gender equality, that foster social inclusion, that fights lack of occupation, that lack of also parenthood, that goes and picks children from poor areas, from slums, and give them a chance to do something good that will serve them for the whole rest of their lives. Mm. So it's really related to the project itself, not really to the organization. The organization can be very small, but what is important is the spirit of the project and the project itself that they are proposing.
A very important program indeed, just like many others, that could transform the face of the private sector in Uganda. But the only way that you can have access to this information is through educating yourself as a business owner and as a part of the private sector in Uganda. Thank you for watching The Business Show. We are taking a break now, but do stay tuned. We shall be right back.